like having a toddler. When I'm trying to work, they want to play. Channel and welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen. I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach, and I'm on the WW or the Weight Watchers Blue Plan. Today I have a video that is highly requested. One of the biggest questions I get as a weight loss and nutrition coach is, how am I supposed to meet my protein goal and what am I supposed to be eating as far as snacks go? It's pretty easy to figure out what protein to add to a meal, right? Breakfast, lunch, dinner. But what do you eat for snacks to help you reach your protein goal every single day? As we know, protein is essential for satiety and also for losing weight and building and rebuilding muscle after we work out. So I'm here today to share my top WW friendly protein filled snacks that are a great choice when you're trying to reach your protein goal. And a lot of these can actually be taken on the go. So it's a double win. So if you're excited for today's video, please give it a big huge thumbs up. And don't forget, if you're new to my channel or you're not yet subscribed, I'd love to have you hit the little subscribe button and of course the bell next to it so you're notified whenever videos are uploaded. Check out the description box down below for my brand new meal planner. It has been a huge hit. We're getting to the end of the first batch, so definitely pick one up before they're gone. Also find my nutrition coaching where I can help you with your macros and your calories and that protein goal that you need to reach every single day, as well as one-on-one coaching sessions in both 30 and 60 minute sessions. You'll also find links and discount codes to all of my favorite things. I will link any of these items that are available to be purchased outside of a regular grocery store, or maybe the price is better online, down in the description box as well for you guys. And last but not least, my Facebook group, another community that would be honored to have you join us. So head on over and join us there. So without further ado, we have a ton of protein-filled snacks to talk about. So let's get started. I'm going to pop pictures up of all of the items that I don't currently have on hand. Otherwise, I'll insert some clips of those items so you can see them up close and personal. I first want to start out with the basics, the protein shakes and protein powders. Protein shakes are a great on-the-go option. They're a great choice for breakfast if you're running out the door because they're packed with protein, vitamins, and nutrients. The thing with protein shakes that are pre-made and ready to go is you want to be mindful of the ingredients. You want to make sure there's not a laundry list of ingredients, not a lot of artificial flavors and sugars. And if you can avoid natural flavors, highly recommend that as well, because as we know, natural flavors are also artificial flavors. So you really watch your ingredient label when it comes to these pre-made protein shakes. I do have a few favorites. First is Iconic. Iconic is a plant-based protein shake, but it's really, really delicious. They have some very unique, individualized flavors. I like this all by itself. Sometimes I'll use this as a base for a smoothie, and a lot of times I'll put it in my coffee to make a protein coffee. Iconic is really, really delicious and has a great list of ingredients. My other favorite clean, delicious protein shake ready to go is Orgain. There's quite a few of the Orgain ones that are really good, but my favorite is the Orgain Clean, and I really like the vanilla flavor. It's absolutely delicious. Again, use it as a base of a smoothie, drink it straight out of the carton on the go, or of course, add it to your coffee for a protein-packed coffee in the morning. Now, if you have time, maybe for a snack pre, post-workout, or even in the morning for breakfast, protein powders make a great option to make a protein shake before you head out the door or while you sit and relax and enjoy your morning. My favorite protein powders, first plant-based, is LiveWell. I love LiveWell because it is a complete protein. There's a difference between a complete protein and an incomplete protein. Complete means that all of its nutrients are intact and it is full of its natural amino acids. Incomplete protein would be free of the essential amino acids and a lot of their nutrients wouldn't be intact. So LiveWell is a complete protein. It is plant-based. It comes in four flavors: vanilla, chocolate, unflavored, and coconut. I love every single one of them. I don't find it to be chalky at all, which is something that is common with plant-based protein powders. So I love that. And it just has a really delicious, rich flavor, and it is packed full of nice, clean ingredients. Orgain also makes a really good protein powder, similar to their protein drink, the clean version. They have vanilla, chocolate, and some other flavors in their protein powder, so that's a great option. And I also really like Less Naked Whey. It's less naked because there's not a lot of ingredients in there. I've only tried the vanilla and I ordered off of Amazon, but it's really delicious and again, a nice clean option for a protein powder. For a quick snack, I am obsessed with cottage cheese, as you guys know. Good Culture is my very, very favorite. I prefer the 4% Good Culture, but I will pick up the low fat if I can't get my hands on the full fat or the 4%. It's nice and thick and a very small curd, and it just has such an amazing, amazing flavor. This little cup is 4 Smart Points, but packs 19 grams of protein. So it's a great way to portion control, but also get in a huge, huge pack of protein. I also really enjoy Greek yogurt. I have a few favorites. I love the Siggy's Full Fat Yogurt. This one is a little bit higher in Smart Points. It's about 5 points per container, but it's only 130 calories. It's very low sugar and a nice clean ingredient label. I also enjoy the WW friendly yogurts like Too Good because it only has 2 grams of sugar and pretty good ingredients. And the Light and Fit is also a great option as well. I don't love the ingredients in that one as much, but it does have a good amount of protein for the little cup of yogurt. And one other one that I see a lot and that I've eaten myself is Oikos Triple Zero. My concern with that is some of them have carrageenan in it, and carrageenan is an inflammatory. So I try to avoid that. I don't have that in my diet at all. So I have to be really selective on the Oikos yogurt that I pick. Again, it's extremely important just to take a quick look at those ingredients. String cheese is another great protein source. That's quick, easy, on the go, and portable. I love string cheese. I prefer the full fat or mozzarella, but really any string cheese is going to be a good option because it is packed with protein and of course some healthy fat. Speaking of healthy fats, I love a good nut butter, peanut butter, almond butter, cashew butter, you name it, I will eat it. It is 3 Smart Points per tablespoon, which is not bad at all because you have to remember that you're getting in a healthy fat, but you're also getting in some protein in that nut butter. I like to spread this into celery with some raisins and make ants on a log. Sometimes I'll add it to my smoothie, or I'll spread it on top of an English muffin or a piece of toast in the morning for breakfast. Another fun thing to do with nut butter is add it to oatmeal. It's incredible. Speaking of nuts, nuts are another great source of protein and healthy fats. Now be mindful on your portion size of nuts because the points and calories can add up rather quickly. Some of my favorites are pistachios, almonds, and cashews. I even love a good walnut. Just make sure you're weighing them out and sticking with a portion size. Even though they are higher in points, they're such a good choice for a snack. They're filling and satisfying due to the protein and the healthy fat content. I always have lunch meat on hand because this is another really good option for a quick on-the-go protein-packed snack. Sometimes I'll just grab a few pieces of lunch meat and eat them on the go. Sometimes I'll roll them up with a string cheese. I love to roll the string cheese up with the lunch meat. Sometimes I will put a little bit of Laughing Cow cheese in the middle of it and roll it up. It's also really good with a dill pickle spear for 0 points rolled up in the lunch meat. It is so incredibly delicious. Ham, turkey, you name it, have it on hand because it's a really easy, low calorie, low point, even 0 point. If it's a 0 point chicken breast or turkey breast, high protein snack. I also love a good turkey pepperoni. I generally always have turkey pepperoni on hand. It is pretty low in points. You can have 15 pieces of the turkey pepperoni for only 1 Smart Point, and it packs a good amount of protein and a little bit of fat as well, so it's a pretty well-rounded snack. I also love me a good meat stick, and you know that I rave about the Nick sticks. It is my favorite meat stick. It is the best bang for your calorie and points a buck. You actually get both of the sticks in the package, the green package, the turkey Nick sticks, for 2 Smart Points, 75 calories and 10 grams of protein. That's for both of the sticks in the pack. Now the chicken one or the yellow package is also the same amount of points. I just don't think it tastes as good. It's a little more dry and it just doesn't have that good flavor of the turkey one. The green package is where it's at. The turkey sticks are delicious. The best and most affordable place for those is on Amazon. I'll link the best price down below for you. I also love beef jerky. Be mindful of the sugar and salt content of the beef jerky that you're choosing. Obviously, beef jerky is going to be a little bit higher in sodium, so keep that in mind. Make sure you're drinking your water, but I always pick my beef jerky up at Costco or Sam's Club. It's the best bang for your buck. This Larissa's one is absolutely positively delicious, and you can have an ounce of most beef jerkies for anywhere from 1 to 2 smart points, so not bad at all, and it's a great pack of protein. I also love a good protein bar, another great portable snack. I do limit myself to one fake, as I like to call it, protein per day, so whether that be a protein shake or a protein bar, but it's just a convenient on-the-go way to get in some protein. My favorite, as you guys know, is Built Bar. For the points and calories, you get the biggest amount of protein for the lower points and calories. Plus, they're absolutely delicious. I love Built Bar. I especially love the revamped formula and some of these amazing flavors that they're coming out with. I also do like the Alani New Bars, but they hurt my stomach. So for me, I'm sensitive to maltitol, which is in those bars. So I have to limit them to once or twice a week, but I do like them. And they're about 5 to 6 smart points a piece, and they pack about 16 to 18 grams of protein. The RX bar is another great option for a protein bar. Pretty clean ingredients with the exception of natural flavors, but they are fairly high in smart points. When you're choosing a protein bar, again, check your ingredients and make sure that you're trying to choose a bar about 220 calories or less, because snacks shouldn't be more than about 200 to 300 calories a piece in order for you to stay within your caloric goal and your smart points for the day. There are a lot of great protein chips out there as well. Quest makes a protein chip. I'm not the biggest fan, but I know that a lot of people love the Quest chips. If you're going to have a chip, have one with a little bit of protein. It just makes sense and helps you reach your protein goal. I also do like the Popcorners Flex Chips. These have about 10 grams of protein per serving, and the barbecue are absolutely incredible. So this is a great option for a protein-packed chip. If you're a fan of pork rinds are actually a good option. They're not too bad in calories or points. They are a little bit higher in fat because they're pork rinds, but they do pack a little bit of protein and a lot of crunch. The Enlightened Bada Bean are really, really good as well. They're a bean, so beans and legumes do have a good amount of protein. So you can always snack on those, but having a bowl of black beans isn't as enticing as maybe these Bada beans. They're a crunchy bean snack, and they're packed full of protein, and actually all of their flavors are really delicious. There are some good dip options out there that have some protein as well. You can dip in crackers, vegetables, really anything into these dips. You know I love the La Terrafina spinach and artichoke Greek yogurt dip. I find this at Kroger stores or Fred Meyer in my area, as well as at Costco. It's the best dip ever. A lot of you have reached out and said that you can't get enough of this dip as well. And because it's made with Greek yogurt, it does have some protein. Speaking of Greek yogurt, non-fat plain Greek yogurt can also be made into a dip. Add your favorite ranch powder or French onion powder or even one of the onion soup mixes to that and make a high protein 0 to 1 smart point dip for those vegetables and crackers. And lastly is hummus. Because hummus is made from chickpeas and chickpeas have protein, hummus is a good protein filled snack as well. Again, dip in your favorite cracker or vegetable. I love hummus. My favorite is Hope because Hope is a nice clean hummus and it comes in a wide variety of flavors. Also, the Wisps Parmesan crisps are so good. They're great all by themselves. You could also dip those in your favorite dip, and I love to top my salad with them in place of croutons to add a little bit of extra protein. And the last protein snack I want to share with you is actually kind of an obvious one, and that is lean meat. I like to buy pre-cooked, pre-done chicken. You can buy these in skewer form, little bites. I know Costco carries quite a few of these pre-cooked, pre-seasoned chicken options. You can even pick up a rotisserie chicken. If you have it ready to go, cut up, diced up, shredded in your refrigerator, it's very simple to just grab 3 to 4 ounces of that and have it as a quick on-the-go snack. You can also use that same chicken to make wraps and top your salad with. So it's just a good option to have a lean, pre-cooked, pre-sliced, pre-shredded protein on hand. So that's what I have for you today. Those are my top WW-friendly protein-filled snacks. If you incorporate a few of these into your diet every single day, you will very, very easily reach your protein goal, which again, is essential for weight loss and satiety. I wanna hear from you guys if you have any other of your favorite protein-filled snacks. Leave those down in the comments so that we can all find some new options to stock our fridge, freezer, and pantry with that are full of protein. If you enjoyed today's video, please give it a big, huge thumbs up. And don't forget, if you're new or you're not yet subscribed, of course I'd love to have you hit the little subscribe button and the bell next to it so you don't miss a single video. Check out my meal planner, links and discounts to all of the things that I shared with you today, as well as my other favorite things and my Facebook group are all down in that description box. Thank you guys again so much for watching. I really hope this helps you out. Again, this is the number one question I get, is how to reach your protein goal. So I hope you found today's video helpful, and I'll see you all in my next one. Bye.